Hello, my little friends. I'm really excited that today we are going to learn a lot about gardening and plants.
What we gonna do today?
Gardening. Let's do it together.
So, are we ready? All right. Let's ask this question. What comes to your mind when we talk about gardening? Soil? Plants? Absolutely right. Let's begin our exciting adventure by understanding a few basics. Soil is a mixture of minerals, water, air, organic matter, and countless organisms that are the decaying remains of once living things. Soil supports plant life and is vital to life on earth. Now, hang on. If you are doing gardening on the terrace, we will need some pots as well. And I got tomato seeds from a local nursery. And why tomato seeds? Because it is one of the easiest plants to grow. Plants begin life as seeds. Seeds need the right conditions to germinate or grow into a new plant. They need air, water, the right temperature, good soil conditions, and the right amount of light. A sapling is a young plant. The part which grows above the soil is called shoot, and we'll discuss it in depth a little bit later. The part which grows below the soil or earth is called the root. Two important elements of gardening are manure and compost. Manure is produced mostly from livestock waste, and when mixed with soil, improves the fertility of the soil. Manure is highly rich in organic matter, thus improves the soil quality, for example, producing nitrogen and other elements which are trapped by the soil. Compost is a mixture of organic residues, the plant waste, a little soil, and our household food waste. We should make compost at home by separating the food waste and make plants very happy.
What is this called? This is not a stick, it looks like a fork, right?
Yeah.
It's called a garden fork, see? Be very careful, it has very sharp edges, right? This is called a garden fork. Yeah, and it is used for loosening the soil in the pot. Now, this is called a hand trowel, okay?
I have that too.
What is that called?
Hand trowel.
That's your hand trowel. We use it to pick up the mud like this, see, and put in the pot. Understand? See this one. What is this called?
The striking.
No. This is called a hand rake or the cultivator. See? When we plant the seed, we till the land by a hand cultivator or a hand rake. See? Try it once.
No. I'm using my hand.
Scissors are handy, but remember, only in the supervision of parents, and I'm watching you. Get some brownie points and gifts from your mom and dad by using newspapers if you are doing terrace gardening. Hint, a donut. Water, you already know it and you get the full points for it. All right. Now that we are experts, let's plant a sapling.
Papa, you can help me.
I'll help you. And what do we need garden fork for?
To put it here and root.
It is used to loosen the soil. See? You see this? What is this?
Mud.
It's mud. To loosen the mud, we use the garden fork.
Mud.
Like this. If you see big pieces of mud, we can loosen it by the help of the
hand.
By the help of the garden fork. Okay? You will see Papa will use manure to put it in the soil and then we'll put that in the pots.
Well, it's actually quite easy. In step one, fill the pot with little soil mixed with manure. After carefully tearing off the plastic coating around the sapling, put it inside the pot. In step 2, Once the sapling is in place, hold it firmly with one hand. Evenly fill the pot with soil. Since we already have some soil at the roots. And finally, we will water the sapling to moisten the soil and give it some nourishment to grow.
And now, what do you do? Now, what would you do? You need to sprinkle some water. Now, where is your water? Not there, in the plant.
Oye, ladki, in the plant.
Now, this is wow. Well done, everyone. Well done, Rimjim. Now, planting seeds is even easier, but we have to understand a few little things. When we choose a pot, the next thing is to make sure that we create a little drainage hole at the base of the pot. In most pots, it will be a marked spot in the center. You just have to take it out and take help of your parents. But you will ask me, what is the purpose of this little hole? It allows water in the soil to drain freely, so adequate air is available for the roots. There are special seeding trays for tomatoes for a professional tomato gardening. However, I have dispersed seeds just for demonstrating the exercise. We have planted the seeds. What's gonna happen next? And this will amaze you. The tomato seed germinates within a week, and by a fortnight it becomes a sapling, a beautiful sapling. Flowering happens in a month's time. Little beautiful fruits appear after a month. In about 3 months, mature tomatoes are ready to be harvested. Now that we can eat sweet tomatoes, let's also brush our knowledge about the plant parts. Check out the green leaves, thin stem, developed roots, and little buds. All these parts have a special function. Stem holds the leaves and provides nourishment to plant. It holds the entire plant. Roots absorb water for the plant. Buds are equally important as they form flowers. And in the initial stage, they protect the flowers. Leaves are the most important part as they contain chlorophyll, which absorbs the sunlight and makes food. Flower is the most beautiful part of the plant. It has a special scent and bright colors which attract a lot of insects. Finally, the part we were waiting for. The fruit you just ate. Fruit is the part of the plant which has excess plant food and seeds. So there you go. You have done a great job today. So my dear little friends and parents, I hope that you enjoyed this educational show. Please like, subscribe and do share with all the kids you know. The Baby Stories will be back next week with another learning show for kids and toddlers. Till that time, stay safe and take care.